Yo, what is going on, guys? This is Daruma here, and we're back with another YouTube video. Woo! And we are doing a creative map for once. I've never done this before, but I've heard tons of people saying I'm really good at making maps, and I should probably show, and I should do videos on it. At least that's what people that I play with, because I help them a lot on their maps. So I'm pretty good at the settings and all that, so I figure out stuff. So, first off, today we're doing a 1v1 map, alright? So here's the basic layout. Looks familiar. Kind of looks like BHE. The only thing missing is the vault and the little portal over there. And there's no, whatever it's called. There is no, whatever it's called. There's no spectator mode. And there's no, starting area, because I'm sure you guys can figure out the starting area. It's just this. Except you change it to, you have it on his, use this island start, and all. Or I'm sorry, pre-game only. Alright, so let's start off with the basics. So, you're gonna use the indestructible gallery. So you first wanna go to galleries, and go down, all the way down to the very, 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 very bottom. Which is right here. You should see this the rocks, and then when you open it up, it's next to the, because some people might not be actually watching the video, they might just be listening to it. It's next to the numbers and the beacon gallery. So when you go into it, it's all the stuff that you need, and it won't break if you pickaxe it or anything, and that's how it won't blow up. Next thing you'll need are these item spawners. These are in devices underneath the sentries. And once you get to those, you just want to place them down as many as you need in a circle, kind of like this. And on the edge, you're going to have spawners. I prefer 11 by 11 with the indestructible tiles. So you just go 11 by 11 and just fill it in. And there should only be 3 items placed down here with, of course, the indestructible tiles as your floor. And that's basically what you want. And you want those 3 tiles to be closest to the center as possible, and we'll get to this later. So, basically, once you get all those tiles down, you want to put your spawners down, all 16, in a big rectangle shape like this. You want 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in a row, and then you want to go 4 that way and just connect them and put the 2 extra wherever you feel comfortable putting those 2 extra anywhere comfortable, anywhere you feel like that is comfortable for you, that you want it to be. So basically, easy and quick player spawn customization. So, see, I'm in the modified option, so this is the only stuff I modified. Enabled during phase, game only, and gameplay only, and use as island start, no. And visible in games, no. And over here, I only did it with one weapon, because I'm not using this. This is legit just for this video. I made a second one. I actually have one of my own. And the only settings for this is visible during games off, time before refresh spawn, instant, time between spawns, instant. The invisible part is very important, so it won't get damaged by the explosives. And once you get your spawn stuff down, like all your spawning and your guns, so you have that down, and you have your floors down. After that, you want to make your checkpoints underneath the stairs. Only thing you want to change is visible during game, none. Right? And you have all that. Then you'll put your ramps. And then, after the checkpoint, that's what you got. You should have the ramps, the checkpoint, and you should have all that done. Now, if we move over to here where these buttons are, you click these and it changes the background. If you want it to where it just turns off automatically, and you want to turn it back on, I don't know how to do that because I'm garbage. But, I know you can do when activated, transmit on channel 99, and that will turn this off and change it to the different one. You can easily put 2 buttons in so you can turn it off. But I have it where I have 2 different backgrounds. So if I want Nebula Purple today, I'll put on some Nebula Purple. If I feel like just Nebula, I'll put on some Nebula. I'll show you how that works in a second. Also, we have the things where if you fall off, it teleports you right to this beautiful rift right here. We'll go through that in a second. And also for the spawn height thing as well. So to do the barriers, all you want to do is come on here, place your barriers down, and for your modified options, you want the barrier style, whatever you want, nebula, whatever, and then enable during phase, all, zone shape, box, hollow. Now these are important. The width, depth, and height is very important, because this will show how far out your island start should be, so it doesn't get affected by the explosives. So you want 40 by 40, and then height is 100, and you want to enable when receiving from 98, and disable when receiving from 99, and that will do make, that means if I was to hit this, it would disable that barrier, and this barrier would turn on, the nebula barrier would turn on, that one will, yeah, this one would turn on after this one is deactivated. Alright, so next one's the nebula, and then this is important, so you want enabled during phase none. If it's on anything else than none, it will be flashy flashy like it is now, as you can see right here. This is how it will be the whole time, so you want that as none. Zone shape, hollow, and these are important because this tells you how far out your island start can be. This is the very outside, and nothing will get destroyed outside. This is where you're going to place your, I would say redstone, because it's not redstone, it's not Minecraft. But this is where you would put in your triggers and all that other stuff to make everything work. So you would 50, 50, and then 100 again, and enable during 99, and disable when you're seeing from 98. Now, these two can vary depending on what you want. But I did the first one as when activate transmit 99, and then you just simply do the other one as 98. So you could do 98, 99. Doesn't matter which one you do. It just matters that you put 99 or 98 in different ones as for when activated transmit one. Now that will activate your barriers and all that, and now to figure out, so if you want it so you, when you hit the ground, you teleport back in like BHE, because you know everyone loved that map, so, and people still play it, which is actually really cool. I appreciate that people still play it, but at the same time, people don't 1v1, it's just a mob pit on creative fill. So if you want one that's like that, and you just want to mess around with your friends on your own map and stuff like that, so here's the settings for the teleportation. It's width 100, depth 100, height is 0.5, so it's, you don't get hit. You don't keep teleporting when you first spawn in, and one player entering zone transmits 100. Now when that happens, when the player enters a zone, you have this rift up here. You want teleporter group, not none. You want teleporter target group as none as well. You also want enable during phase gameplay only. Teleporter rift visible, no. Play visual effects, no. Play sound effects, no. Conserve movement, momentum, no. And you want teleport to when receiving from 100. Alright? So, now that we got those things out the way, it was a lot to intake, so I'm going to show you what I mean. Alright, so see? Invisible. Pump spawns. Alright? You can't see the explosives or anything. See checkpoints there. We're not going to mess with the buttons or the explosives yet, because I haven't showed you that part. But if we jump off the side, like I showed you, you should teleport right to where that rift is. And then, as well, if you come up to here, it says you want to change the interact text to whatever you change what it does. So if it says, so if this changes to nebula, which it should, you just hit change to nebula. And it took my one mini ammo, because you gotta put one mini ammo in. I forgot to tell you, you gotta put one mini ammo in these things, and you have to have unlimited ammo on. Unlimited ammo for it to work. Alright, so then when you give it that one, then you can keep doing it over and again. But if I was to hit this one, it would turn back to the purple nebula. Alright? So we know if we jump off and spawn there, those two things work. If those all work, great. Move on to the next step, which is now. If not, I'll have a list of timestamps right now. Everything that we've been through, and go back and see if what's wrong and compare the settings. So, to get that, so, as I was talking about, the one light ammo that you would receive at the beginning of the game, you would want to come out here and place it down so it doesn't get destroyed. You want to place team settings in the inventory, and all you want to do is change end round when receiving from, and this can be any channel, and I'll explain that in a little bit. But that's all you have to change, and then you just put one mini ammo in, and that's it. That's all you put in. So, and then on the, you go into your settings, which I'll show what the settings should be for it to work later. But you go into settings and turn on infinite ammo, and it should work perfectly. All right. And now we're gonna get to our explosives now. So let's start with our button. Our button is simply trigger sound disabled. Interaction text is reset. Enable when receiving from 30, disable when receiving from 32, when interacted with transmit on 1. This is important because when you tap the button, sometimes it double taps, and if you tap it too much, you'll end up ending the game because after your bombs run out, that inventory thing says, hey, we have nothing else to destroy. Let's tell the game to end. So that's when it ends the game. All right, so now we got that down. So once you got all those settings down, you want to copy and paste over here, and we want to go to over here, which will start the magic of the explosives. So we want to come here, not here. This is how, all right, no, we do want to come here, never mind. So you want to make this as a toggle pulse on and off, and you want to start sequence on channel 1. And you just want this to be wind trigger transmit 32. This will disable the button. And down here is the same thing, except wind trigger transmit on 30. So that will enable the button again. And this is so you don't double clip or triple clip on accident. Now we got past all that. We got the button working. If it doesn't work, rewatch that. If it does, congrats. And the next step is the explosives. So we have channel 1 reserved to start the... We have channel 1 to start the sequencers. So we have to start on channel 2 for the triggers. Alright? But first, let's go over these settings. We have length. And very important right here. Length, normal. Width, 4, activation type, toggle, pulse, on and off, and start sequence when receiving from channel 1. That's it, alright? And it also depends on the way you place... it doesn't. This is all you need. That's it. Normal, 4, turn, pulse, on and off, and channel 1. Alright, since channel 1's been taken up, we move to 2. So we have triggered by player, off. When triggered, transmit on channel 2. That's all you need. Don't turn it on, don't turn it off, that's all you need. If you want to turn off the sound for the triggering, go ahead. But from this far away, I don't think you can actually hear it, so it doesn't matter. And for channel 3... Okay, so for this one, you want channel 3, of course, because it's the next one. And you want triggered by players off, transmit every X triggers. 2, when triggered, transmit on channel 3. Alright, so what basically mean the... trigger on every X triggers means, so if this goes off once, this one won't be activated. When it goes off a second time, it will be activated. That's so not every bomb blows up at once, so it will stay here until it gets hit again. And that's what I meant by disabling the button, so that doesn't happen, so you can conserve your bombs. Alright, now we move on to the next one. Triggered by player off, transmit every X triggers, 3, when triggered, transmit on 4. Alright? And it's the same thing for number 5, except this is different. It's when triggered, transmit on channel 5, transmit every X triggers on 4, triggered on by player, off. So that's all the same, but what changes, it's not going to a bomb. This one is going to over here, which will end the round after being hit four times, saying, hey, we ran out of bombs, end the game. That's why this is key and why you need it. All right, now we have all these settings down. We want to come over to our magical bombs that will make this game work and set them up. So this should be number two, if I remember correctly. Yes. Okay, so our first one is invulnerable, so it can't take damage. Owning team 16, blast radius 20, beacon scale extra small, hide health bar one tile, visible during aim, off, play audio and sound effects, off, collision during games. You want to make sure this is off. If this is not off, then all of them will blow up when one goes off. You want that off. Destroy when receiving from channel 2. And all the settings are the same, except that it will vary on whatever it's receiving from. So like this one is our, I didn't put it in order, so this would be our second, this one would be 3, and this one would be 4. So if we were to start the game, everything should work. And if not, I'll have timestamps right now. So you can go back and check what you did wrong. So 1, 2, 3, and here's the fourth one. And it should end the game. Just like that. That's what that does. But you can place as many as these as those explosive things as you want. Just copy the settings, do all the same, except you're just going to change the channel one up. When you get to 30 and 32, you want to skip 30, you want to skip 31, and you want to skip 32. Go straight to 33. So the 30, because no, 31's not being used, but so you don't confuse yourself, just skip 30, 31, 32, and go right to 33 and continue on, if you're doing that many. Also, you don't need these underneath the stairs. You can simply place them right here, along this, and it would still work. Alright? So once you have all those settings done, your map is in full effect, it should work, right? But that's not all. So what about the height limit? I haven't talked about that, right? So let's go up to the height limit, shall we? So we go up to the height limit, and we run into this blue thing, and then the barrier. And we look over here, and we see our magical floating thing, and we go down and look up, and we see what we did. So all you want to do is copy the same thing for the same, you want the same barrier style or a different one, say it's up top, so you want this to be stars instead of whatever else you did. So if you did blue skies or brick, so it's walls, and then up top is this, it doesn't matter. It's whatever barrier style you want. And then you want width 100, depth 100. You want enable when receiving from 98, disable when receiving from 99. But make sure whatever this barrier style is the same as the other barrier style down there that controls enabling and receiving from 98, or it won't work right. Same thing over here. Nebula. None. Make sure this is none, or it'll be flishy flashy like the ground is if you don't. So you want 100, 100, 99, 98. That will make it so you can't see this floating device, right? So when you come up here, you would hit this blue thing instead of the barrier. Alright? So this one is simply just allow weapon fire, yes. Zone width 100, zone depth 100, zone height 2, so your barrier's not, you're not hitting the barrier before the height limit. So you want to hit, you're going to hit the height limit before you hit the barrier, but the barrier is there so you don't see what's up top. What's all doing this, alright? And then you have one player entering zone. You want to transmit on 100. And that should teleport you down to this teleporter right here. If you guys had any trouble with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below. I will be checking the comment section and answering any questions. Or you could just say, hey, I'm having trouble. Can you add me? And I would gladly add you and come in your world one day and help you build it. And if you want to just try to figure it out in yourself, all the timestamps of everything I talked about will be showing up on the screen right now. So if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, subscribe, turn on notifications, and I'll see you in my next how-to creative map. Peace.